Holy manoli.
Yes. A couple weeks of transition.
I just went over by the window and I'm like, God, this thing's coming in there.
So I said,
oh, yeah, here. Yeah. But I just went over by the camera. I can feel the cold air.
Stands for a while. Yep. Paul, yeah.
I do my standing when I do my clap.
I
Yeah, she went to the antique store today. I'm shocked. Hello, how are you?
Very good today.
Got a wall sign, so it matters.
Why should we have eyes on it?
I don't know if they're real. I think my guys are busy on the weekend.
You got it?
It's cool, right?
No.
Move it around.
Yeah. I was concerned.
Before it hit you. I had a problem.
I like the reasons I said she may come by here for us. I think that she is.
So I just moved over now, which was about.
So.
Thank you, Judy. I wouldn't know where you were.
Well, good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
If we could just start off at the main table here, just so you know who everybody is. We'll start down the end for introduction.
I'm Dan McDonald, I'm the Student Services Director.
I'm Lily Chong.
Judy Johnson, Chair of the School Board.
Ogden Ashby, Superintendent.
Katie House, Business Administrator.
And Richard Hartman, Principal of Architects.
Ed Jansen, President.
Michelle Simon, Budget.
Kim Simon.
Nancy Dale, Budget.
John Ordway, Chair of Budget.
Lisa Simon, Budget.
Talon Dale, Budget.
Third Boy, Budget.
Paul Cass, I do Budget.
Nice meeting everybody, thank you. I think all of you have gotten your binders. We tried to get all the information, I'll go over the budget in a minute, but the binder has a number of things in that you'll see for information purposes. Obviously, we've got the budget narrative starting up. That just tells the increases and decreases from the budget as we work through and develop the budget to start with, as well as some information on the function codes, which gives you a little bit of background. One of the things you're going to see in the budget this year is we tried to add more detail. Some of the budget lines in the past were, I'll say, lumped together, and we've tried to detail them out. So we'll identify them as I go through the budget, trying to get those into the appropriate lines. Then you've got the budget. You've got the revenue sheet that we'll go over as well. The default budget is in your packet. We'll briefly touch on that. We provided enrollment class size numbers, so you'll get an idea as to what our size is and what our teaching staff is instructing. And our warrant articles, I'll go over those, but there's a number of those in there, and I'll let you know the ones that are possible for later. The tax impact, a little bit of information on the delivery session and other budget development schedules, as well as the board goals and what the school goals focus on this year. So just a little bit of additional information for you. We're not going to go over all of that tonight, but certainly if you have any questions at any time, let us know. I'd like to turn to the budget itself. You'll see I believe it's a pink sheet in your binder. It says FY 19-20 budget. And what I'd like to do, unless there's some objection, I'd like to go page by page, hit on the highlights, explain some of the changes and the differences in the budget, and move on through. And anybody at the table here as well, if you've got additional information, they'll chime in from time to time as well. Along the way, if you want me to slow down or speed up, or if you have any questions, just feel free to jump in and interrupt me anytime.
Nancy, if you're going down through a line, there might be something someone here might want to ask a question about at the time.
Yep. I'm going to go page by page. I'm not going to touch on every line because some of them are repetitive. But by all means, at any point in time, jump in and ask a question while we're on that page. So we'll do our best to answer all of your questions. Okay?
Yes.
So starting off on the first page, we've got teacher salaries. You'll see a slight increase with teacher salaries. Some of that is for the longevity for eligible teachers. There's a little bit in there, as well as the literacy interventionist. We moved that from part-time to full-time, so that's a slight increase there as well.
I have a question on that line. My question is how many students do you anticipate on this budget? For teachers on this line?
Well, if you look to the enrollment tab in your binder, you're going to see all of our total enrollment, and then it breaks it out by grade level.
And that's in 2018. You're going by the facts of October 2018 to prepare this.
Right, and what we've done for next year, obviously, is bump everybody up. We know that, you know, we've got our sixth grade moving out to Marshwood. So we take those numbers off, and then we take our best guess and get there.
Okay.
Can you just explain what longevity means? Is that step track?
No, in the contract, in the collective bargaining agreement, there is a longevity piece for the teachers who have been here. So it's not step track. In this particular budget, you're not going to see any step track because there isn't a
So this longevity is in addition to step and track increases?
For some teachers, yeah.
Isn't the longevity after they get off of the step process, is never longevity kicks in?
Exactly.
So it's not, yes, addition to...
It's after 9 years, so they get at least $28 each year.
So it's not in addition to, it is once...
Right, it would be when they get to the top step.
Okay, so after they go through all their steps and tracks.
Correct. Sorry, that's what you're saying. As you go down through, you'll see the tutor salary, and that's an increase of $14,742. That's an example of putting it in the correct line. That was invited last year, but it was lumped together, and we wanted to better identify that, so we pulled that out and put it into a line. So it looks like an increase, but it's really just a readjustment in the budget. Sub-salary line is a pretty substantial decrease. We've looked back at the actuals for the last few years and tried to take our best guess there, as well as I believe we separated out, this is another example. All of our substitutes were taken out of one line before. Now we've got substitute lines for our special education, substitute for nurse. So it'll just better identify it in the budget instead of lumping all of them. You'll see those, I'll identify those later.
Sorry, I'm going to take a quick one.
Yep.
Is that prescribed percentage of the contract? It's a dollar, okay, per person. Yes. Thank you.
The next number of lines are the benefits, health, dental, life, FICA, and retirement. You'll see that we were fortunate this year and your health insurance came in at a minus 9.7%, which was less accepted. So obviously that helped us out a bit. You'll see the dental insurance is an increase of 2.3%, and the other increases and decreases that you see for retirement. So those adjustments. And as I go through the budget, when I say benefits, those are what we're talking about throughout the budget. Internet access is another increase, and Rich, would you like to talk about that a little bit?
Yes. So Tom Lavelle is our contracted IT person for the school. One of the things that has happened over time is an increase in technology in the building. I have an example just yesterday in one of our math classes. Kids were on a certain website all the doing math activity, and because everyone was on at the same time, in addition to other places in the building, kids got kicked off. So it was down to two or three students able to use that program and the internet to pull up the alternate activity in order to finish the required lesson. And so what Tom is recommending to do is look into setting up higher speed line. He's currently out trying to get quotes from different agencies so that if this passes the budget, that we'll be prepared to get that rolling for August 1st. It's a dedicated higher speed line that is for the school itself. It is eligible for grade services, so 40% of the cost for installation. Monthly costs could be reduced so that we're seeing that towards the school. So the increase is a one-time $5,000 installation cost, and then an increase of about $200 a month on the actual internet cost because it's a higher speed. And so that would be a more expensive cost.
Well, you're going to be booking this line out front.
Tom's plan is there is the capability to be down somewhere across Locust Street near the railroad tracks.
It's not going across the railroad tracks, is it?
I don't believe so, but...
Because it takes an actual... have to go out to get by.
I don't believe so.
Okay.
100% certain on that. I don't believe that.
Is it a fire alarm thing?
I knew I should have put it in the council this week.
That's why.
It does say fire.
Yes, it does say fire. So I'm pretty sure. I'm not the tech guy, all I know is we're going to this month. And what it will do is allow multiple spots in our building to access technology at the same time. And we're fortunate to have a number of teachers who are comfortable with that. The level of need is just so phenomenal once they are using the correct application. It's much.
The next lines are the tuition. You'll see that the middle school and high school tuition is in there corresponding to the, obviously that's a snapshot in time looking at the number of students that we're sending up, the number of students that are graduating. If we were to get any move-ins in the next month or two, then obviously we would adjust that number accordingly, but that's our best cut at it right now. The tuition is $10,598 per student. And then obviously we prepaid the, like I said, the snapshot of the students we have.
Is that for both middle and high school?
Middle school, you'll see in there MS, LEAs, that's the middle school number, and then HS right under it, that's the high school.
But the per student rate, 10,000,
yes.
Is the same,
yes.
For both?
Yes.
How'd you come up with the 1,225,000? You got 110 students, and you got one extra, so that'd be 11 times the 10,598. One in the high school, two in the grade school, a middle school, right? Yeah.
Yeah, it's always a moving target, trying to guess who's going to move in and who's going to move out. And the tuition number, I had to deal with this in my last superintendency as well, where any tuition number for students moving in and out at the middle school and high school level, the only place to make that up is 3-year elementary budget. So there's, I believe, three markers.
There's a total of three. It just designated two in the middle and one in high.
There's also money attached in there for CTC students. That has always been in the budget in case students take classes at a career and technical center. So that money's also in there.
See, what confused me, I took the 111 and multiplied it by the 10.
Are you taking the current enrollment? Yeah, so I moved the students though. So I moved out the seniors and...
Projected was 110 plus 1. I just didn't know how you come up with the one.
Again, some of that is the CTC money, the free markers, and then the enrollment that we're trying to guess. Okay. Trying to get that as close as possible.
Yes.
For class.
So So all the 9 teachers that are here this year are coming back next year?
Correct. The positions.
The positions.
The positions.
No, for the next year.
Right. When we talk about the budget, we talk about positions, not people. So are the people coming back? That's up to them, but...
Oh, I thought you had 1 retired.
9. We've got 9 positions.
Yeah, I know, but...
Yes.
Now, the point I'm bringing up is if you had 9 and 1's retiring, did you ever think of going to 8 teachers?
We've looked at that. We've looked at different configurations. That was a discussion that Rich and I had a couple months ago, looking at all kinds of different configurations, and it was deemed that we needed to stay with the same complement. But we didn't do that.
So I'll just study it.
Yes, and the board is very cognizant because of the history of policy, and we keep that in front of both the principal and the superintendent. That is important that every time you have to do that.
Thank you.
So is it based on, classroom size?
Well, there's a lot of, and I'll let Rich speak just a little bit, but there's a lot of discussion that goes into that. It's not just class size. It's grade level, it's configuration, it's needs. So a lot of things that they don't have to speak a little bit to that.
Yeah, it's easy to take the total number and divide it. Okay, divide it by 8 rather than 9. It's 19 bits a class, which sounds pretty decent. But then, because we're a multi-grade school, look at the configurations and the possibility of configurations, and it really messes with the numbers, where some classes would end up 25 or more, others would end up continuing to be 15 or 16, and trying to configure it so that they're all relatively equal, it just didn't work itself out, so that our kids would have equal opportunities if they could go through a different year.
On the top of the second page, again, the supplies that I just talked about, detailing those out, putting them in the appropriate lines, so you'll see some increases with the corresponding decrease on the page 1. Subscriptions, the $9,400 decrease. This is another example of there were a lot of things that were drawn out of that last year, and we have a decrease in that line, but we've got an increase. Classroom workbooks and classroom reference books, again, reclassifying it so it's actually budgeted in the appropriate line, so we can track that over years instead of pulling multiple lines out of one budget line.
I think that's a wonderful idea. If we could just have what the old total was so that we know that it's still staying within what the old total was, but just being broken out.
If you look up under subscriptions, that 13,000 was what was passed for the current year.
Okay.
Can I add to that though? The hard part is there's a $13,000 amount I'm walking in this summer. I didn't know what that $13,000 was for. This year, I have teachers propose what they can do for next year. So once the budget is passed, I have exactly what they can pass for. Whether or not they can purchase it based on the budget that's passed or not. So I have a better idea. So some lines are bigger. Some of those subscriptions, one of those subscriptions that we purchased through there, we didn't have another line to purchase them from.
Okay.
So in some cases, subscriptions look like it's down like 400 and then up to 12,370. That's not the case. It's because, you know, there's a different needs each year. Subscriptions wasn't just subscriptions.
Okay, I got it.
Hopefully, we'll get forward.
Thank you.
Under technology, new equipment, you'll see a $30,700 decrease. This is the same thing. We had one technology line, and we were purchasing new equipment, replace equipment, as well as equipment for a lot of different areas. Music, art, those types of things. So you'll see a decrease of $30,000, but underneath that you'll see corresponding lines for new equipment in the appropriate area. Again, over time, over the next few years, you're going to be able to track how much are we spending for new equipment in music over time, technology over time, and the way it was budgeted before, you never could really tell because it was lumped into one area. So that's why the $30,000 decrease. Right under that, technology equipment replacement. There's a replacement cycle every year that a certain number of computers and other equipment need to be replaced. So that's the majority of that. And then going down through the corresponding new equipment lines underneath that, as well as onto the next page, you can see the different new equipment tasks for art, science, math, furniture. So again, you'll be provided over time with a lot more detail than having that in one new equipment line and guessing where it goes.
Replacement on the carpets. You've got the first and second grade in kindergarten. And those carpets aren't going to be attached, are they? They're just going to be like a scatter rug or something?
Yeah.
Thank you.
On page three, we start going into special education. Again, with special education, we're taking a snapshot of the students that we have presently, both at the elementary level and the high school and middle school level. And as we move through, if students move out or their needs are lessened, then we'll adjust it accordingly. You'll see the mainstream coach under special education at $18,000. This is, you'll see a decrease there of $18,900. If you turn back to the first page, you'll see the tutor salary that I mentioned is new, $14,000. Again, this is detailing it out so it's a lot clearer. It's actually in the right place in your budget. So the tutor in the first page, $14,000, that's coming out of special education, really being budgeted for where appropriate. Let's see, the substitute salaries, special education, $5,000. Again, previously in the budget, you had a substitute line that I identified that's down. This is taking $5,000 out of that previous line and putting it into substitutes for special education. So it's, again, budgeting it in the appropriate area instead of pulling everything out of substitutes and not knowing exactly
I just have one quick question. On the SPED elementary teacher, is it one teacher or two more than one? It says teacher salaries.
It's more than one.
Okay. Full time, part time, two full time?
Two full time. What's that? Two full time.
Thank you.
Part of one of them is allocated under the high school.
Yeah, you see underneath down the bottom, yes, the middle of the page, there's a high school allocation.
Moving down to the $5,900 decrease, again, that's all your benefits for special education, instructional staff. Same thing with the health and the retirement and the dental, the same percentages that we had discussed. Moving on to page four, you'll see a decrease of for special ed tuition for Summersworth. That was the last student that was in Summersworth, is that right? For special education, so that's the decrease there. And the high school and middle school, again, those are for the kids that we have, the specific students that we have, the needs that are attached to them, and that's the snapshot of time that we have right now. Moving down a little further, special ed tuition, the decrease of $253,000. There was some discussion as to the billing of special education students in the past, and we had some conversations with Dr. Nash over in Marshwood, and it was a situation where basically we were all budgeting for the special education students. They were interpreting the contract one way, we were interpreting it another way, and we had a meeting and came to an agreement, which correspondingly decreased the budget by $253,000.
I want to give you kudos for finding that.
Absolutely.
Good job.
As you've been told, every year, we will take time to get it all straightened out. And last year was a bit of turmoil, but I would also like to commend student director, always thought our sped person, and about to get on, so he gave you the hard work on making that everything moved on.
Well, I've got to say, Pam's done a lot of work at making sure that she goes over every bill that comes in, making sure that every student is attached to the bill and all the services are attached to that. So without looking over that carefully in detail, that's the type of things that are oftentimes very confusing and cumbersome to do. But she did a great job, and Katie always does a nice job of making sure that the budget stays there.
Is there a document that's definitely a legalized document that's going to be in the files for the Natchez meeting this year, correct?
We've got that.
Thank you.
We've got that. We had an agreement, and we both signed off on it.
Sorry, you were talking about the $253,000, correct?
Yes.
This isn't that for a private school sped, not Marshwood?
No, that under the budget.
Yeah, Marshwood, yes, she's right. Marshwood is up top. The $253,000 is for out of district also.
Right,
they don't have Marshwood, but it's other districts.
So the savings that you're referring to is actually the $38,000 for high school, right?
Yeah, I was looking for the wrong line.
That's okay. So my question to that is,
yes,
that's telling me that there was a change. But what happens if that's not there and somebody moves in with that similar situation?
For the other district.
Correct.
Yeah. That's a moving target. It's a moving target. You know, we do our best to identify the need for our students and kind of anticipate the need for our students. But you're absolutely right. Somebody could move into our district with high needs tomorrow, next week, next year, and it's a challenge.
We do have a reserve fund for special ed.
Right. What do you know? What's in the fund?
It's actually in your
If the police chief wants to take on that task.
He has. He thinks it's his job, he moves forward.
And that is very, very appreciated. However, if he is not chief, someone else may need to be paid, and that's why it's a good question.
So I understand where you're coming from.
But that's all.
But maybe our town, bringing it to somebody else from another town, doesn't seem fair without the...
No, but this is actually news, and it's all of us, including board. We do no work for our students.
I didn't realize you had...
So this is simply news, that's all.
I know, but he's saying this is a Semmsworth person who does this, that will be coming to Rollins when the need is occurring.
I can certainly call up the chief and...
You should, just talk to him about it.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's a respectful thing to do, but it's always been a news.
And it is nice to have it, our own news.
Thank you for that. On to page five, again, guidance for the staff, except for the benefit changes.
Can I just make a point, because we do have some members that these don't have any changes in the salary because you don't have a contract. I want to make sure that we're clear about it.
Right.
These are contractual.
Right, presently, we don't have a collective bargaining agreement.
And the benefits, do you notice they're all collapsed into one line? Because that was a concern last year with our teachers because of HIPAA. For some of the function code, we have one person working there, so if we put in their health amount, you could identify the plan they take, so now we collapse it all into one line, so that way. I mean, there's still detail in our budget, but for everybody's, when we present it to the town, it'll all be collapsed so that you can't identify.
Speaking of that, is there any way of getting the total compensation minus the health insurance for every teacher like we've gotten previously? Because there hasn't been, I have one from 2017 that has everything, FICA, retirement, everything except for health insurance, the total compensation for every teacher.
You're talking about the sheet that lists position and or salary? That usually comes with the top of the budget.
Well, that's why I'm figuring now would be...
Did someone talk about this one?
Well, when you say it's Sam, what do you think of?
I thought my grandma's number in there.
It's a space near the guidance office area. Hold a lot of our meetings there. Room, but part of them is set up for students who are escalated in the regular classroom. There's a space for them to go and be escalated. There's some students there that help them calm down. That's the word is that. It's supposed to be a calming space so that they're not in trouble. They shouldn't even be in the office. It might be something that's happened at home. There's not a lot of focus in class. So, we're looking for a partition because of, the center spaces and there's a workstation for teachers and the conference area. There's a set there.
Thanks.
Well, sounds peaceful, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
right below that, you've got your nursing services. Again, not a lot to talk about there. Fairly static. Need that, speak salaries. And we static with that, only adjustments for further changes in the benefit costs. PT, OT, professional services below that. Questions on that page? It's really straightforward. At the bottom, and moving on to the next page, on page seven is the librarian, the library services. Again, holding a fairly tight budget.
Okay, so this is one of the track changes.
Yeah, anytime you see an increase, that would just be a fact that you don't have to set.
contract changes in something like this, but not the teacher's regular education, because you said that wasn't included in the regular education.
There's nobody moving tracks there.
But longevity is not added into the regular education account here?
Yeah, there was longevity.
Okay. I thought I had heard that it wasn't added yet.
The only thing that's not here are steps, which are part of the collective bargaining agreement, and it wouldn't be in here anyway, because it's a separate one.
Yes.
The rest of page 7, you've got your school board expenses, school board secretary. And really nothing to report there.
Yeah, but I'm also on this page and not, but on the voting, for the printing of the ballots, where does that money come out of?
It has its own line, I believe.
I couldn't find out, not in this case.
I think it is under your general supply line.
Yeah.
Supervisor checklist. It's from the general supply.
School board general supply.
Thank you.
On page 8, about a third of the way down, audit services, an increase of $2,000. Again, increase is based off of actuals. Legal services, an additional $5,000 there. There's some discussion about if we're going through the withdrawal process, they're taking some additional attention from the attorney that needs to be inquired about, so that would be increased that line to $5,000. A little further down, SAU assessment. That's the SAU budget, and that's a decrease of $10,139. And moving into school administration at the bottom of that page and onto page 9.
Oh, supervisor, the checklist, you got them at 235. There's only one election. Last year there were 3 elections. Why is it level funded?
Line in your budget, to better detail that out. It just helps with identifying.
Makes it easier to follow things.
Right. A little more difficult this year because we're moving everything, but in the future, it'll be a lot easier. Absolutely. Page 10, your custodial benefits. Again, you're going to see a big decrease, and right under that, a big increase. So that, again, that's just putting it in the appropriate place. Custodial equipment, $4,400 increase. You'll see the number over what was in the stuff for basic. Under utilities, you'll see that there's an increase in oil, $5,000. We look back at the actuals and try to get a little bit of history there. So we bumped that up a little bit. It seems like it was under budgeted in the past, and we want to make sure that we had an appropriate amount come out. Down the bottom, you'll see, down the bottom and at the top of page 11, you'll see maintenance repairs and a decrease and some other. Again, we're trying to get these in the right lines. Grounds maintenance on the bottom of page 10, $18,000. You can see put the notes in there so you can see exactly what we're proposing for the budget. And then moving on to page 11.
Can I come back to utilities?
Yep.
Okay, you've got level funding on water and sewer. Everything I've heard, the water and sewer rates are going up.
Yes, we didn't know that when we were talking about it. And it's still not published what it's going to be, so it's going to be big.
And also, if you look back to the actuals from 18, we only spent $2,600 of the $38 in last year's budget, so we do have a little bit extra.
Okay, we looked at that, and so we felt that that would cover it.
How will it detail on the parking, additional parking on the side of the building?
Yep. One of the things that happens when we have buses, number of parking issues out on the street, the side streets. So there's going to be a little bit of history about how we're competing with two spots on different spots of the building. And on this side of the building where our trash receptacles are now, recycling receptacles, he's looking to cut that bank and add, he said 6 to 8 other spaces to fit in there next to the ones that are currently there and still have space for two receptacles. Increases a little bit and get more people on the property and out of the streets.
On page 11, you'll see maintenance repairs and I'll let Katie take that.
Yeah, just one thing I wanted to note on that one. So even though there's a $31,000 decrease, $93,000 of that was a war article from last year. So when you're looking at that, that is part of that. So even though it says 31,000, really it's nine, it's an increase of 60 because the 93,000 came off from the warrant article. And it's due to these things that are listed here.
The COPLA, you gotta bring this up to Tom. Now you were gonna do it last year out of surplus money, but you didn't do it. Are you gonna do it out of surplus money or are you gonna wait for this budget?
The school board's intention is to wait for that.
Moving down to equipment maintenance agreements, again, you'll see the we tried to detail out what's under that line as well. And then there's a decrease down the bottom of the page, upkeep of machinery, and again, we're trying to reallocate the money into the appropriate line, so we're trying to identify those two as well, so you can see where everything is. On page 12, starts your transportation. Again, those are your contracts for student or
really corresponds to the decrease we were seeing on out of district placements. Since we don't have a student out of district, we don't have transportation to go along with it.
How long's the transportation contract good for? When's it come up for renewal?
It's 5 years. I think we're going, this will go present to our third year of that.
And I can double check on it.
It's an automatic thing to do, maybe?
Yeah.
Then at the bottom of page 12, you've got your retirements that are in the collective. On page 13, again, we had one line that was tuition workshop reimbursement. There wasn't an identified line for professional development, bringing consultants into the building and professional development for our teachers. So we, you can see a decrease of $24,000. Right under that is $12,000 increase. Again, that's a reallocation to make sure that we get that in the appropriate lines to better identify that. And down the bottom of the page is your transfer to capital reserve fund.
That was for the warrant articles from last year, and that money is in the book.
So at the present time, the budget that's in front of you is a decrease of $307,292.
Just a couple of questions. Can we, I'm just trying to understand that you're going to have a little bit of money in this year. So the 152,000 that was adopted last year, 93,000 of that was from warrant money, right? So that means that there was about $60,000 in that. And so this year, you're doubling that maintenance line item as part of the operating budget. Yes, so the items that are listed in the next scenario. And then just so here, so of the $307,000 savings this year, $207 was one of those, right?
Thinking of the 93 and the 75.
So leaving a net decrease to the operating budget of about $100,000.
$93,075
to build the budget. That's in the budget. Yeah, but it's included in your budget. So the total warrants was about 207, and then your ending decrease was 26, so $100,000
in net savings to the operating budget.
Because it excludes transportation in the city.
That's an interesting question, because a lot of times people will compare per pupil cost, and that's the dilemma, because if you look at the state average, a lot of people take their overall budget, divide by the number of students, and then wonder why it's not the same as the state figure. Because you do need to make the same services and transportation in the state's out of there. So you can do that, but it's just not going to be a comparable number to the number of the state. Under revenue, I'll let Katie go through the revenue sheet.
So your revenue is up by a little over $70,000. Majority of that is increased to our state RPT. See what an estimate in November. An estimate that they give us is definitely not the final number by any means. We don't get that final number until the fall in October. So it's a best guess. So that's up by about $147,000. The other difference is taking out the $75,000 that gets transferred to the capital reserve from last year. So we take the two, that's the difference. And then we're getting a little bit less in kindergarten aid. And that's just based on what we're estimating for students. $1,100 per student for those students. That's something new for in the current year. We started to get that.
Warrant, so we put that in as a marker.
What happens if you don't reach a
if we don't reach an agreement, then it will be status quo. The dollars in your budget, the contract stays the same, the pay stays the same. And then there is a perhaps possibility of going to fact finding and then having an agreement come forward to the voters. But time is of the essence of these things.
So then you would have a year without a contract because it didn't get in time.
It is possible.
It is possible, but not necessarily. As Dr. Gomes was saying, maybe an agreement is reached after that. There may be a call for a special election to consider just that. Just that.
And they do
that.
That
is a possibility.
They do that for contracts?
They do. We would have to petition the state for a special meeting, but they said they do not.
We had one special ed student move in, and we had to have a special meeting.
Yeah. Sorry, I have to go back to the public. So do you trade the occasional contract? The law budget 36, the transportation debt.
No, because we go with the actuals of what we actually are going to do. Okay, so that's an actual, yeah. Thank you.
Moving down to the warrant articles, Article 7 is your expendable trust fund for regular education tuition. I believe that was created this past year. And the thought process behind that is that right now, again, we're taking that snapshot in time. We're budgeting for 3 additional students as a marker for movement. If we get a number in that expendable trust over the years built up to 3-4 tuitions, you may want to budget right to the number. So that would assist getting your regular budget a little bit closer and tighter. Because you've always got that capital reserve to fall back on should you get 1 movement, 2 movements, 3 movements.
I believe that's 2 students because it's only 22,000 that aren't written.
It's 3 in the budget, 2 in the warrant.
Oh, you still have.
We have 3 in the operating budget and we're putting in 2 for the warrant. The idea of that is that's actually 1 in the budget, but 2 more in the warrant article, and then we'll have 4 in the year after that. We'll have to put in enough in this reserve fund that we'll feel comfortable with, say, 4 student reserve.
Yeah, it's nice to have that. I know in my last position, there were some years where we had 2 students move out or, you know, came through as a wash, and we had 1 year where we had, I believe we had 11 students move in. That's an awfully big number.
And some of you may remember that 3 years ago we had 15 students move in, and we had to actually freeze the budget here at Baltimore Grade School. And that was unfortunate because the only place we can make it up is what is spent in this school.
So that's Article 7, and Article 8 is the Building Improvement Capital Reserve Fund for $75,000.
This does not affect taxation.
Do you have any thoughts about what you would use those dollars for, what you're building up for?
Absolutely.
And they are things that need to be revenue on both ends.
the boilers, windows in the annex, windows in the main building. So these are all things that, you know, will bring us into the hundreds of thousands of dollars pretty quickly. So that's the idea for this fund, is that we will continue to put some money in it each year so that we can not have these hurt so much when they come on.
That's the goal, and as many of you up there and sitting back here remember, a lot of this goes back to the IED study that was done a number of years ago now, and our facilities director has, you know, keeps that in mind and gone through, and we're getting one of the things that somewhere here in the budget is getting getting an actual cost for one of the next things that we need to do, because now so many years have passed, we have to go out and find out what it's really going to cost to do it this year. So those kinds of things are ongoing.
Question. The one and only meeting that I went to for the school board was you were receiving a presentation on an addition or a modification to your building, and you decided not to go forward with that?
That is correct. At this time, we've decided not to go forward. We still have more, we need to understand more actual costs. We have ballpark figures, and we chose to try to get more specifics.
In the near future, do you plan on coming up with a building program on what these expenses are, rather than these are about 3 or 4 years old, these numbers?
We have the plan,
yep.
The five-year plan, but they don't have any numbers attached to them at
okay.
this point.
Because I still got the 2017, where you got the projected things that you wanted to do.
Yes, and you're right, Charlie, those projected costs came from, actually from the IED study and they have not been reassessed at current rates.
The next part of your binder is the tax impact, and I'll call it Katie.
So included in there, I did a summary sheet of each article and how much it would be your tax rate impact. Also in there are spreadsheets included with different value of homes and what that would see. So on the summary, because there's a decrease in the budget of $307,292, that results in a $1.10 decrease in the tax rate. And then the only other impact would be the increase in revenue. And because it's an increase in revenue, that's also a decrease on your tax rate of 25 cents. So the total right now, as it stands, would be a decrease of $1.35 on the tax rate.
I'm just going to say that's the most amazing news I've heard in 5 years.
I'm assuming that you went by $280,000 for a dollar.
It's on your, you look on the other.
Yes, yeah, I know, I'm just having
you. 279,506,
279,
yeah.
Yeah, we rounded up on
the yeah. It's a really great spreadsheet because you can just type in the dollar amount and calculate it all for you. So
yeah.
It's good for town meetings, so you can do it really quick on the fly if somebody asks.
And the last two dividers, one is just the schedule for upcoming meetings and the deliberative session, and then the board goals we put in there is the focus of the school board goals for this year. So hopefully that information was helpful to you. I hope our presentation added some clarity to the budget. My hat is off to Rich coming in here in July and working with the staff and trying to get the ground running, so he's done a wonderful job, and certainly the school board asking us some tough questions along the way and clarifying and scrutinizing every position. So, and then, you know, I can't speak highly enough of my staff, they do an outstanding job. So, I hope that was.
I just want to say that in all my years, this has been the best prepared presentation for the budget.
And it sounds like, make sure we do.
Well, once you get out of the tourism, yeah, it's going to be a lot better.
It's easier to read.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, and thank you very much for the way this is organized. Very easy to follow. I'm glad you corrected the special ed trouble.
No, well, it was huge, and I also, while we're giving kudos around, actually, in the process of interviewing Dr. Yonsky and in public meetings and in private meetings with board members, budgeting was very, and how we went about budgets was very big, high on our list, and it's one of the reasons it's here.
So
thank you.
So I know it's in the paper and stuff, I just want to make sure I understand.
combination of things there. And I think I went at it a little wrong when I was explaining it. And correct me if I'm wrong. The 253 was the out-of-district placement. And working with, you know, bringing kids back into district, servicing their needs. Some kids age out, some kids move out. So that number is the out-of-district placements that fluctuated. I believe it was the $38,000 in the budget that was...
And it was probably more than that, because that also includes an increase situation,
okay.
So...
Okay, that's what I got, $38,000. Yeah. I want to make sure that... Okay, thank you.
Any clues about the collective bargaining agreement that we might be seeing?
Nothing?
We can't talk about it until it is. It cannot be spoken about in public until it is completed.
Okay.
We're in negotiations right now, and to this point, we don't have an agreement. We're going to mediation next Wednesday with the board negotiators, as well as the union negotiators, the teachers, and the parents. And we'll see where we go from there.
Really good job with this part.
Yes, thank you.
Any other questions?
No.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
With that, is there any other business that someone wants to bring before the board?
I have something. Based on questions and conversations that we had at our budget meeting with the fire department on equipment and clothing and trucks and stuff, the fire chief has asked me to extend an invitation to have the budget committee come and tour the building, look at the equipment, and ask as many questions as you want to. So, to have a night that you all can, or most of you can make it. Is there any nights that are better than others? Wednesdays are off, so I'll be in here on Wednesdays. I was thinking Mondays are off because I can't come, but I was thinking of a Thursday, if Thursdays look for you guys. You can do as early as next Thursday.
Mr. Chair, while you're all doing this, would you like for us to dismiss our hard working?
Yes, absolutely. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good night. See you tomorrow night.
Oh, should I go out to bring your packet tonight?
We'll be here tomorrow night.
Sure.
Next week. They're coming in next week. They're
They ask for my birthday, don't forget to bring them.
And I think it's been like 2 weeks.
But are they meeting on Wednesdays forever? I mean, is that, that could be a problem if they're never here. That's the whole point of having, right? Okay.
I guess maybe we have to have Frank to tell us that. I thought they met on another.
Yeah, they never used to be on Wednesdays because they were always here before.
Yeah.
He should be here next week.
Any other business?
No, motion to adjourn now.
Second.